All right, hello everyone. I hope you had a great weekend and that you're ready for the new semester. Please remember that specials change on Monday. So if you had music Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and last marking period, now you have music on Tuesday, Thursday. So I'll remind you all in the announcements tomorrow morning, but heads up on that. Grades are due Tuesday and we'll be wrapping up all things from semester one. Okay, new groups for RTI are going to be at this link. Oh, sorry, somehow that link did not transfer over. I'll fix that up. Remember that any students remaining in your classroom, you are their tier of intervention. Check their iReady scores for their next steps and what they need. If you're not sure how to do that, come see me or Dr. Willer or any of our RTI staff. They will be able to show you how to do that. Mid-year data forms, I will have those in your mailboxes in the next few days. Please complete them and return them to me. Also, please update your DRA data on the school-wide data sheet. So you can find that at this link. And it looks like this. What I'm mostly looking for is that on your DRA tab down here at the bottom, you come in and at middle of the year, or some grades have it as marking period two, please put in your DRA scores for all of your students. Make sure that gets updated soon so that we have accurate data on our kids for their reading scores with DRA. All right, a little bit of follow-up for our staff meeting. One of the things that came up was a question about if perhaps some of the scores are low because of the COVID shutdown. And I'm sure there has been some loss of learning from that. But if we take a look at our math growth data and our reading growth data from last year, so here's the math. And as you can see, the tiers are still pretty unbalanced. Which is similar to what we're seeing this year. So last year, tier one, which is the green tier, went from 1% to 5%, so up by 4. Actually, our tier one is double that this year. It's 11 and it's up to now 22%. So actually, our data is better this year than it was last year. So we can't use COVID as an excuse because it's actually better. We have more kids in green right now than we did last year. Tier two last year went from 61 to 77. Currently, we're 55 to 56. So our tier two is a good jump smaller as well. Tier three is about the same. So last year it went from 38 to 18. So far this year we've gone 34 to 22. So tier three is still about the same. Tier two is smaller and tier one is much bigger currently. So math is pretty good. We do need to beef up our tier three so that those students are moving out of tier three and into tier two, and tier two students into tier one. One of the things that Gerald and I talked a lot about on Friday is that a big issue with the math, especially using iReady, is that the problems are all multiple step or higher order thinking problems. They're not what we used to see in everyday math, which used to be a formula that the students just had to plug and chug. Now, a big issue is the vocab and breaking apart the problem into the steps that need to happen. So, you have to keep in mind, yes, we did implement a new curriculum, but we want to make sure that we are using that new curriculum with fidelity, but also working real hard to push those tier two kids to tier one. All right, and then if we look at our reading data from last year, again, we see a very unbalanced pyramid here. So in 1920, tier three, our red group, went from 42 down to 22. And that's about where we're at right now. It was 38 to 25. Tier two last year went from 54 to 72. And again, a much better group for us this year, 44 to 42. And tier one is actually quite a bit better so far this year than last year. Last year went from 4% to 6%. And currently it went from 18 to 32. So while our tier is getting stronger, we still need to remember those things that we talked about at our staff meeting. Our current data obviously is not because of COVID. We've done a much better job currently than we did last year. Our whole group instruction must get stronger. We have to use the tools that we purchased and implement them daily. That is going to require a big focus on everyday math, or not everyday math, sorry, iReady, a move away from everyday math, and also on our guided reading and literacy footprint program, as well as the Hegarty for phonics. Our tier two and tier three is still too full. We have bright students. Where is that disconnect? What is it? A lot of what we see is a phonics issue. So it's a vocabulary that they're hung up on, but they're hung up on it because it's a phonics issue. They can't break the word apart, and then they cannot comprehend or understand what they're reading because of that comprehension piece and the ability to break down the vocab. So definitely some things that we need to work on. We are a strong team. We're doing great things, but we need to get really intentional with what we're doing so that the data that we have shows our hard work. You all work way too hard for these to be our results. Finally, one thing that I've really thought about over the weekend is that the COVID shutdown did have a few blessings, one of which is that we did not have the M-STEP last year. If we did, with a third grade reading law in effect, looking at this data that we had with only 6% of our kids in the green, we would have had a huge amount of retentions based on our student data last year. So knowing that and looking at our current data, we need to continue to make our improvements. So let's really get down to business this semester and get those kids moving. I want to see lots more in the green by the end of the year. All right, enough about the heavy stuff there. Number four, virtual board meeting. The board meeting this month will be held virtually Tuesday at 6 p.m. and you can join the meeting at this link. Semester grades, please have the grades in by Tuesday at midnight. Let Tracy know if you want her to print them. Otherwise, you can print them from Skyward and get them to Tracy. You can add notes if you'd like, but we want to mail them by the 20th. Picture retakes. We were able to get Life Touch to come do our retakes on Tuesday afternoon. They will be doing the high school graduation composite photos in the morning, so we'll have them here after lunch. And again, National School of Choice Week. I brought that up last week. It happens next week. And as a way to brighten up our month, I thought it'd be fun if we did a few activities along that theme. So I'll work out those details and get those rolling. Sand table voting. Mrs. West is ready for the sand table designs to be voted on. The submissions are on the wall outside of her classroom, and the voting page is posted next to her door. Here are our events for this week. We have the virtual board meeting. Grades are due in Skyward. Picture retakes. Semester report cards. I have a principal's meeting on Thursday. And that's it. So let's have a great week, everyone.